Hi and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope everything is well with you and that you really love a colorful Christmas card because that is what you're gonna get today. I used a new layered pine 3 stencil from Trinity Stamps. I absolutely love this one for creating backgrounds, and you will see here that I'm using some distress inks to create my background here and the pattern that will be the pine 3s. And I also used a couple of different shades here. I used a yellow one called, I think it's Mustard Sea. And for my darker color that I put on the bottom of my tree, I used Dried Mahogany. For my second tree, I used Spiced Marmalade and Abandoned Coral. I will go in with a light touch here on my first layer and just create a base color for my trees. For my third color combination, I'm making sure to clean off my stencil, of course, really carefully between each color switch. I used one of my favorite colors, that is Cracked Pistachio. And for the bottom part, I went in with some Moved Lawn. And then I decided that I needed a fourth color combination. And I did with a blue one. This is Peacock Feathers, and I love this one. I had a little bit of trouble with this stencil over here because my adhesive that I had to keep my stencil in place slipped around, so that was the only problem I had there. You will see that I'm fixing it quite a couple of times. You will see I have the same problem here. Going in with my first color combination, the Mustard Sea and Dried Mahogany. And then the first layer is done. I will go in with my second layer here. There are actually three layers that you can use, but I only used the first and the last layer, I would say. The one with the least space. So now I'm going in with a really heavy hand here, so the color will really be popping for this layer. And we will have the softness of our first layer in the background. So here you can see how the first two layers turned out. And you will see I will clean off my stencil now. Do it one more time here for this part. Going in heavily with that Spiced Marmalade and the Abandoned Coral. And I will do it one more time with a Peacock Feather, and then our background pattern is soon done. I really love this. I really like how it turned out. I had imagined that it would turn out something like this, but it was actually even better in real life. I love creating colorful Christmas cards, and I hope you will enjoy this one. I have a couple of more really colorful Christmas cards that will be coming soon. And I wanted to have a colorful sentiment as well. So I created a rainbow pattern here, just with some of the colors that I use for my background. You will see I will use that Noel dye. That is also one of the new ones from Trinity Stamps. I decided not to include the blue one, so I just went with the Peacock Feather as my last color here. And then I will die cut it. And I will also die cut the white shadow that comes in this die set a couple of times and stack them together to create a little bit of a raised effect against our background. If we didn't have this white shadow, it would be a really busy pattern, and I think the sentiment would be lost in the background. So I'm really liking that this die come with this beautiful shadow. And I'm fiddling around with these small pieces. I don't know actually what this is called, the dots over this letter, but in the Noel it should be this one, so I included it. And also I adhered my panel down to a light blue card base here and a second layer and then a white card base. So it had some dimension as well, and to tie in the whole card. And then I went over this with a glitter pen, you will see here in a second. Coated the whole sentiment. And then I will go in with some glossy accent to raise this up and create a fun effect. This is something I really like to do on my Christmas cards. I think it creates a beautiful effect, and it makes that you, it feels like you really used and like made this card from the heart, and the recipient will see that you put in a lot of time with this card. I believe overall this card took me about an hour to create, so that is pretty fast. If you are looking for a fast project, I would say that a stencil would be a fast way to create a Christmas card. Maybe you can skip some of the steps like layering the die cuts and so on. You will see my daughter's hand here, she was here helping me. And this is how the card turned out, and I hope you liked it. If you did, please subscribe to my channel, and I will be back soon with more Christmas cards. Bye!